domestic followers are fans of India Gulab today. It's activist and teacher for Zaria Suresh back with sheer delight from the 88th video on Angle of Publication on YouTube today, 2nd October 2020. Topic for discussion today is nuclear power plants and safety issues. There are many different ways in which the abundance of energy around us can be stored, converted and amplified for our use. The energy sources have been split into three categories. Fossil fuels, renewable sources, and nuclear sources. The fossil fuels are here are coal, petroleum, and natural gas. Renewable energy sources are solar, wind, hydroelectric, biomass, and geothermal power. The nuclear powered sources. Are fission and fusion. Fission is splitting, fusion is joining. Scientists believe that global warming is caused by the greenhouse effect. The greenhouse effect describes accumulation of carbon dioxide in Earth's atmosphere. A layer of gas forms that traps heat inside the atmosphere that are acting as a glass ceiling of a greenhouse. Because heat is trapped by the carbon dioxide, it is believed that the Earth is slowly warming. A potential danger of global warming is the melting of the so-called polar ice caps in the north and the south poles. This occurrence would cause the ocean level to rise and perhaps flood many coastal cities. Materials on the low end of the energy scale, such as wood and charcoal, create the most pollution. Sources on the high end of the energy scale, such as natural gas, burn very cleanly, resulting in less air pollution. Hydroelectric systems make the use of energy in running water to create electricity. In coal and natural gas systems, a fossil fuel is burned to heat water. The steam pressure from the boiling water turns propellers called turbines. These turbines spin coils of wire between magnets to produce electricity. Hydropower systems also make use of turbines to generate electrical power. However, they do so by using the energy in moving water to spin the turbines. Water has kinetic energy when it flows from higher elevations to lower elevations. This energy spins the turbines and this is coupled with the electric generators to generate electricity. The name solar power is actually a little misleading. In fact, most of the energy known to man is derived from the sun, in some way from the sun. The energy of the sun can be used in many ways and plants grow, they store the energy of the sun. Then when we burn those plants, the energy is released in the form of heat. This is an example of indirect use of solar energy. Yeah, we are harnessing solar in some way or other, directly, indirectly. This form we are interested in is directly converting the sun's rays into a useful energy source, electricity. This is accomplished through the use of solar collectors, as they are commonly known as solar panels. Solar power is actually one of the cleanest methods of energy production, because solar panels simply convert the energy of the sun into energy that mankind can use. There are no harmful byproducts or threats to the environment. One major concern is the cost of solar power. Economics. Solar panels accumulators are not cheap, and because they are constructed from fragile materials, semiconductors, glass, etc., they must constantly be maintained and often replaced. Further, since each photovoltaic panel has only about 40% efficiency, single solar panels are not sufficient power producers. However, this problem has been offset by the gathering together of many large panels acting in accord to produce energy. Although this setup takes up much more space, it does generate much more power. Differences in atmospheric pressure due to differences in temperature are the main cause of wind, because warm air rises when air fans of different temperatures come in contact, the warmer air rises over the colder air, causing the wind to blow. Wind generators take advantage of the power of wind. Long blades or rotors catch the wind and spin. Like in hydroelectric systems, the spinning movement is transformed into electrical energy by a generator. The center of the earth can reach 12,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Just imagine if you could tap that heat for our own use. Well, geothermal systems do just that. The earth's crust is heated by the decay of radioactive elements. The heat is carried by magma or water beneath the earth's surface. Some of this heat reaches the surface and manifests itself in geysers and hot springs through the world. Geothermal power can be used directly to heat buildings. Further, the pressurized steam from superheated water beneath the earth's surface can be used to power turbines and thus generate electricity. Tides are caused by the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun and the rotation of the earth. Near shore, water levels can vary up to 40 feet. Only a few locations have good inlands and a large enough tidal range, about 10 feet, to produce energy economically. The simplest generation system for tidal plants involves a dam known as barrage across an inlet. Sluice gates on the barrage allow the tidal basin to fill on the incoming tide by high tides and empty through the turbine system on the outgoing tide, also known as the ebb tide. There are two-way systems that generate electricity on both the incoming and outgoing tides. Tidal barrages can change the tidal level in the basin and increase turbidity in the water. It can also affect navigation and recreation. Potentially the largest disadvantage of tidal power is the effect the tidal station can have on plants and animals in the estuaries. Tidal fences can also harness the energy of tides. A tidal fence has vertical axis turbines mounted in a fence. All the water that passes is forced through the turbines. Waves are caused by the wind blowing over the surface of the ocean. There is tremendous energy in the ocean waves. The total power of waves breaking around the world's coastlines is estimated at 2 to 3 million megawatts. The west coast of the US and Europe and the coast of Japan and New Zealand are good sites for harnessing wave energy, tidal wave energy. Wave energy. One way to harness wave energy is to bend or focus the waves into a narrow channel, increasing the power and size. The waves can then be channeled into a catch basin or used directly to spin turbines. There are no big commercial wave energy plants, but there are a few small ones. Any try for splitting apart a nucleus will result. It will cause a tremendous energy to be released. This energy could be released in both forms of heat and light. In a harnessed, controlled way of doing this, a useful energy for producing electricity is possible. Doing this advance would result in a big explosion as seen in an atomic bomb. Nuclear power plant. Uranium is the element used as fuel. Uranium is found in many parts of the world, but in low quantity. It is loaded into the reactor in a tiny pellet form inside long rods. Fission, meaning splitting, is what happens in a reactor. Here, the uranium atoms are split in a paced controlled chain of reactions inside a reactor. Intensity of crashes are harnessed by inserting taking of control rods. Byproducts of such reactions are radioactive materials. If released, they would be gravely harmful. Knowing these strong structures must keep the materials in the case of any accident, the released heat energy could be used for boiling water in the core of the reactor. So instead of burning fuel, you may use the heat of reactor core. By sending the hot water around the nuclear to the heat exchanger section, water-filled pipes produce steam needed for steam turbine. In another form of nuclear reaction, joining a smaller nuclei makes a larger nuclei. Such a process in turn changes the hydrogen atoms to helium. The result, heat and light we receive in the Earth. In a more detailed explanation, two different types of atoms, deuterium and tritium, combine to make a helium plus an extra particle called neutron. The advantage of fusion is an abundance of supply hydrogen, as well as it is less radioactive material than fission. Power plants are classified on the type of fuel and the type of prime mover installed. Nuclear power is the use of nuclear reactions, either fission or fusion, as discussed, that release nuclear energy to generate heat, which most frequently is then used in steam turbines to produce electricity in a nuclear power plant. Nuclear power can be obtained from nuclear fission, nuclear decay, and nuclear fusion reactions. Presently, the vast majority of electricity from nuclear power is produced by nuclear fission of uranium and plutonium, thorium also. Nuclear decay processes are used in niche applications such as radioisotope thermoelectric generators. Generating electricity from fusion power remains at the focus of international research. Civilian nuclear power supplied 2,563 terawatt-hours of electricity in 2018, equivalent to about 10% of global electricity generation, was the second largest low-carbon power source after hydroelectricity. As of December 2019, there are 443 civilian fission reactors in the world with a combined electrical capacity of 395 gigawatts. There are 56 nuclear power reactors under construction and 109 reactors planned with a combined capacity of 60 gigawatt and 120 gigawatt respectively. The US has the largest fleet of nuclear reactors. Generating over 800 terawatt hours zero emissions electricity per year with an average capacity factor of 92%. Most reactors under construction are generation 3 reactors in Asia. Nuclear power has one of the lowest levels of fatalities per unit of energy generated compared to other energy sources. Coal, petroleum, natural gas, and hydroelectricity each have caused more fatalities per unit of energy due to pollution, air pollution, and accidents. Since its commercialization in the 1970s, nuclear power has prevented about 1.84 million air pollution-related deaths and the emission of about 64 billion tons of carbon dioxide equivalent that would have otherwise resulted from the burning of fossil fuels. Accidents in nuclear power plants include the Chernobyl disaster in the Soviet Union in 1986, it's part of Ukraine, the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster in Japan, in 2011, and the more contained Three Mile Island accident in the US in 1979. There is a debate about nuclear power. Proponents suggest the World Nuclear Association and environmentalists for nuclear energy contend that nuclear power is a safe, sustainable energy source that reduces carbon emissions. Nuclear power opponents such as Greenpeace and Nuclear Information and Resource Service and NIRS, NIRS, contend that nuclear power poses many threats to people and the environment. In the US, the discovery of the nuclear chain reaction led to the creation of the first man-made reactor, the research reactor known as Chicago Pile 1, which achieved criticality on December 2, 1942. The reactor's development was part of the Manhattan Project, the Allied effort to create atomic bombs during World War II. It led to the building of large single-purpose production reactors such as X-10 pile for the production of weapons grade plutonium for the use of the first nuclear weapons. The US tested the first nuclear weapon in July 1945, the Trinity test. The atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki taking place 1 month later. In August 1945, the first widely distributed account of nuclear energy, the pocketbook, The Atomic Age, was released. It discussed the peaceful future uses of nuclear energy and depicted a future where fossil fuels would go unused. Nobel laureate Glenn Seaborg, who later chaired the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission, is quoted as saying that there would be nuclear-powered Earth to Moon shuttles, nuclear-powered artificial arts, and plutonium-heated swimming pools for scuba divers and much more. The same month, with the end of the war, Seaborg and others would file hundreds of initially classified patents, most notably Eugene Wigner and Alvin Weinberg's patent number 2.736.696 on a conceptual lightweight water reactor, LWR, that would later become the U.S. primary reactor for naval propulsion and later take up the greatest share of the commercial fission electric landscape. The United Kingdom, Canada, and the USSR proceeded to research and develop nuclear energy over the course of the late 1940s and early 1950s. Electricity was generated for the first time by a nuclear reactor on December 20, 1951, at the EBR-1 experimental station near Arco, Idaho, which initially produced about 100 kilowatt. In 1953, American President Dwight Eisenhower gave his Atoms for Peace speech at the United Nations, emphasizing the need to develop peaceful uses of nuclear power quickly. Was followed by the Atomic Energy Act of 1954, which allowed rapid declassification of U.S. reactor technology and encouraged development by the private sector. The first organization to allow nuclear power was the U.S. Navy with the SIS-1W reactor for the purpose of propelling submarines, and aircraft carriers. The first nuclear-powered submarine, USS Nautilus, was put to sea in January 1954. The trajectory of a civil reactor design was heavily influenced by Admiral Hyman G. Rickover, who, with Weinberg as a close advisor, selected the pressurized water reactor design, PWR, in the form of 10 megawatt reactor for the Nautilus, a decision that would result in the PWR receiving a government commitment to develop an engineering lead that would result in a lasting impact on the civilian electricity market in the years to come. On June 27, 1954, the USSR's Obnix nuclear power plant, based on what would become the prototype of the RBMK reactor design, became the world's first nuclear power plant to generate electricity for a power grid, producing around 5 megawatts of electric power. On July 17, 1955, the Borax 3 reactor, the prototype to later boiling water reactors, became the first to generate electricity for an entire community, the town of Arco, Idaho. In 1957, International Atomic Energy Agency, IATA, was launched. The world's first commercial nuclear power station, Calder Hall, at Binskill, England, was opened in 1956 with an initial capacity of 50 megawatt per reactor, 200 megawatts total. It was the first of a fleet of dual-purpose Magnox reactors, though officially codenamed Pressurized File Producing Power and Plutonium, PIPA, by the United Kingdom Atomic Energy Agency, UKAEA, to denote the plant's dual commercial and military role. The first commercial nuclear station to become operational in the U.S. was the 60-megawatt shipping port reactor at Pennsylvania in December 1957. The total global installed nuclear capacity initially rose relatively quickly, rising from less than 1 gigawatt in 1960 to 100 gigawatt in the late 1970s and 300 gigawatts in the late 1980s. Since the late 1980s, the worldwide capacity has risen much more slowly, reaching 366 gigawatts in 2005. Between around 1970 and 1990, more than 51 gigawatt capacity was under construction. In 2005, around 25 gigawatt of new capacity was planned. More than two-thirds of all nuclear plants ordered after January 1970 were eventually cancelled. A total of 63 nuclear units were cancelled in the U.S. between 1975 and 1980. During the 1970s and the 1980s, rising economic costs and falling fossil fuel prices made nuclear power plants then under construction less attractive. In the 1980s, the U.S. and 1990s in the Europe, the flat electric grid growth and electricity liberalization also made the addition of large new base load energy generators economically unattractive. The 1973 oil crisis. Had a significant effect on countries such as France and Japan, which had relied more heavily on oil for electric generation, 39% and 73% respectively, to invest in nuclear power. The French plan, known as the Messmer plan, was for the complete independence from oil, with the envisaged construction of 80 reactors by 1985 and 170 by the year 2000. France would construct 25 fission electric stations, installing 56 mostly pressurized water reactor design reactors over the next 15 years, though foregoing the 100 reactors initially chartered in 1973 for the 1990s. In 2018, 72% of French electricity was generated by 58 reactors, the highest percentage by any nation in the world. Some local apportionment to nuclear power emerged in the US in the early 1960s, beginning with the proposed Bodega Bay Station in California. In 1958, which produced conflict with the local citizens, and by 1964, the concept was ultimately abandoned. The late 1960s, some members of the scientific community began to express pointed concerns. These anti-nuclear concerns related to nuclear accidents, nuclear proliferation, nuclear terrorism, and radioactive waste disposal. In the early 1970s, there were large protests about a proposed nuclear power plant in Weil, Germany. The project was cancelled in 1975. The anti-nuclear success at Weil inspired opposition to nuclear power in other parts of Europe and North America. By the mid-1970s, anti-nuclear activism gained a wide appeal and influence, and nuclear power began to become an issue of major public protest. In some countries, the nuclear power conflict reached intensity unprecedented in the history of technology controversies. In May 1979, an estimated 70,000 people, including the governor of California, Jerry Brown, attended a march against nuclear power in Washington, D.C. Anti-nuclear power groups emerged in every country that had a nuclear power program. Globally, during the 1980s, one new nuclear reactor started up every 17 days on average. In the early 1970s, the increased public hostility to nuclear power in the U.S. led the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission, AEC, and later the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, NRC, to lengthen the license procurement process, tighten engineering regulations, and increase the requirements of safety equipment. Together with the relatively minor percentage increases in the total quantity of steel piping, cabling, and concrete per unit of installed nameplate capacity, the more notable changes to the regulatory open public hearing response cycle for the granting of construction licenses had the effect of what was once an initial 16 months for project initiation to the pouring of first concrete in 1967, escalating to 32 months in 1972, and finally 54 months in 1980, which ultimately quadrupled the price of power reactors. Utility proposals to the U.S. for nuclear generating stations at 52 in 1974, felt a swell in 1976, and have never recovered, in large part due to the pressure group litigation strategy of launching lawsuits against each proposed U.S. construction proposal, keeping private utilities tied up in court for years, one of which having reached the Supreme Court in 1978. With permission to build a nuclear station in the U.S., eventually taking longer than any other industrial country. The sector facing utilities are having to pay interest on large construction loans, while the anti-nuclear movement used the legal system to produce delays, increasingly made the viability of financing construction less certain. By the close of 1970s, it became clear that nuclear power would not grow nearly as dramatically as once believed. Over 120 nuclear proposals in the U.S. were ultimately cancelled, and the construction of new reactors ground to a halt. We have cover story in the February 1985 issue of Forbes magazine commented on the overall failure of the U.S. nuclear power program, saying it ranks as the largest managerial disaster in business history. According to some commentators, the 1979 accident at Three Mile Island, PMI, played a major part in the reduction of the number of new plant constructions in many other countries. In 2006, Brookings Institution, a public policy organization, stated that new nuclear units had not been built in the U.S. because of soft demand for electricity, the potential cost overruns on nuclear reactors. Due to regulatory issues and resulting construction delays, according to some commentators, the 1986 Chernobyl disaster in USSR, now Ukraine, played a major part in the reduction of the number of new plant constructions in many other countries. Unlike the TMI accident, the much more serious Chernobyl accident did not increase regulations or engineering changes affecting Western reactors. Because the RBMK design, which lacked safety features such as robust containment buildings, was only used in the Soviet Union. Over 10 RBMK reactors are still in use today. However, changes were made. Both the reactor Bolshoi, Marsh, Church, Snortsky, Kanalny, RBMK, also known as light water graphite reactor, LWGR, themselves, and in the control system, amongst other things, to reduce the possibility of similar action. Russia now largely relies upon drills and exports a variant of the PWR, pressurized water reactor, the water energetic reactor, WWER, also known as VVER, with over 20 in use today. An international organization to promote safety awareness and the professional development of operators in nuclear facilities, the World Association of Nuclear Operators, WANO, was created as a direct outcome of the 1986 Chernobyl accident. The organization was created with the intent to share and grow the adoption of nuclear safety culture, technology, and community where before there was an atmosphere of Cold War secrecy. Numerous countries, including Austria, Sweden, and Italy, have voted in referendums to oppose the phase out of nuclear power. In the year 2000s, the nuclear industry was expecting a nuclear renaissance and increase in the construction of new reactors due to concerns about carbon dioxide emissions. However, in 2009, Petteri Tapana, the director of Strux Nuclear Power Plant Division, told the BBC that it was difficult to deliver a Generation 3 reactor project on schedule because builders were not used to working to the exacting standards required on nuclear construction sites since so many new reactors have been built in recent years. In 2018, the MIT Energy Initiative Study on the Future of Nuclear Energy concluded that together with the strong suggestion that government should financially support development and demonstration of new Generation 4 nuclear technologies for a worldwide renaissance to commence, a global standardization of regulations needs to take place with a move towards serial manufacturing. Of standardized units akin to the other complex engineering field of aircraft and aviation. Following the Tohoku earthquake on 11th March 2011, one of the largest earthquakes ever recorded, and a subsequent tsunami off the coast of Japan, the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant suffered 3 core meltdowns due to the failure of the emergency cooling system for lack of electricity supply. This resulted in the most serious nuclear accident since the Chernobyl disaster. The Fukushima Daiichi nuclear accident prompted a re-examination of nuclear safety and nuclear energy policy in many countries and raised questions among some commentators over the future of the renaissance. Germany approved plans to close all its reactors by the year 2022. Italian nuclear energy plants ended. In Italy banned the generation but not consumption of nuclear electricity in a June 2011 referendum. China, Switzerland, Israel, Malaysia, Thailand, UK, and the Philippines reviewed the nuclear power programs. In 2011, the International Energy Agency halved its prior estimate of new generating capacity to be built by 2035. nuclear power generation has had the highest bigger ever fall year on year in 2012, with the nuclear power plants globally producing 2,346 terawatt-hour of electricity, a drop by 7% from 2011. This was caused primarily by the majority of Japanese reactors remaining offline that year and the permanent closure of 8 reactors in Germany. The Fukushima Daiichi nuclear accident sparked controversy about the performance, importance of the action, and its effect on nuclear power plants' future. The crisis prompted countries with the nuclear power to review the safety of the reactor. Reactor fleet and reconsider the speed and scale of planned nuclear expansions. In 2011, the economist's opinion that nuclear power looks dangerous, unpopular, expensive, and risky, and suggested a nuclear phase-out. Jeff Sachs, early institute director, disagreed, claiming combating climate change would require an expansion of nuclear power. Investment banks were also critical of nuclear soon after the accident. In 2011, German engineering giant Siemens said it would withdraw entirely from the nuclear industry. In February, the US NRC approved the construction of 2 reactors of the Rockchill Electric Generating Plant, the first approved in 30 years, 3-0. In August 2015, following 4 years of near zero fission electricity generation, Japan began restarting its nuclear reactors after safety upgrades were completed, beginning with the Sendai nuclear power plant. By 2015, the IAEA's outlook for nuclear energy has become more promising. Nuclear power is a critical element in limiting greenhouse gas emissions. The agency noted that the prospects of nuclear energy remain positive in the medium to long term, despite the negative impact in some countries. In the aftermath of the Fukushima Daiichi accident, it is still the second largest source worldwide of low carbon electricity. And the 72 reactors under construction at the start of last year were the most in 25 years. As of 2015, the global trend was for new nuclear power stations coming online to be balanced by the number of old plants being retired. 8 new grid connections were completed by China in 2015. In 2016, the BN-ADD 800 sodium-cooled fast reactor in Russia began commercial electricity generation, while plans for BN-1200 were initially conceived. The future of the fast reactor program in Russia awaits the results from MBIR under construction multi-loop generation research facility for testing the chemically more inert lead, bismuth, and gas coolants. It will simply run on recycled MOX, mixed uranium and plutonium oxide fuel. As on site, pyrochemical processing close to fuel cycle facility is planned to recycle the spent fuel waste and reduce the necessity for a growth in uranium mining and exploration. In 2017, the manufacture program for the reactor commenced with a facility open to collaboration under the International Project on Innovative Nuclear Reactors and the Fuel Cycle. It has a construction schedule that includes an operational start in 2020. As planned, it will be the world's most powerful research reactor. In 2015, the Japanese government committed to the aim of restarting its fleet of 40 reactors by the year 2030 after safety upgrades and to finish the construction of the Generation 2 OMA reactor now. Nuclear power plant. This would mean that approximately 20% of electricity would come from nuclear power by the year 2030. As of 2018, some reactors have restarted commercial operation following inspections and upgrades with the new regulations. While South Korea has a large nuclear power industry, the new government in 2017, influenced by the vocal anti-nuclear movement, committed to halting nuclear development after the completion of the facilities presently under construction. In 2016, the U.S. Energy Information Administration projected for its base case the world nuclear power generation would increase from 2,344 terawatt-hours in 2012 to 4,500 terawatt-hours in 2040. Most of the predicted increase was expected to be in Asia. As of 2018, there are over 150 nuclear reactors planned, including 50 under construction. In January 2019, China has 43 reactors in operation, 13 under construction, and plans to build 43 more it should make it the world's largest generator of nuclear electricity. Zero emission nuclear plant, an important part of the climate change mitigation effort. Under the IEA, a sustainable development scenario by 2030, nuclear power and CCUS would have generated 3,900 terawatt hours globally, while wind and solar 8,100 terawatt hours, with the ambition to achieve net zero carbon dioxide emissions by 2070. In order to achieve this goal, on average, 15 gigawatt of nuclear power should have been added annually on average. As of 2019, over 60 gigawatt in nuclear power plants was in construction, mostly in China, Russia, Korea, India, and UAE, United Arab Emirates. Most countries in the world were constructing small modular reactors, with one in Russia connected to the grid in 2020. Countries with at least one nuclear power plant is planning phase includes Argentina, Brazil, Bulgaria, the Czech Republic, Egypt, Finland, Hungary, India, Kazakhstan, Poland, Saudi Arabia, and Uzbekistan. The future of nuclear power varies greatly between countries depending on the government policies. Some countries, most notably Germany, have adopted policies of nuclear power phase-out by the year 2022. At the same time, some Asian countries such as China and India have committed to rapid expansion of nuclear power. In other countries such as the UK and US, nuclear power is planned to be part of the energy mixed together with renewable energy. Nuclear power plants convert the energy released from the nucleus of an atom via nuclear fission takes place in a nuclear reactor. When a neutron hits the nucleus of a uranium-235 or plutonium atom, it can split the nucleus into two smaller nuclei. This reaction is called nuclear fission. The nuclear fission reaction releases energy and neutrons. The released neutrons can hit other uranium-plutonium nuclei, causing new fission reactions, which release more energy and more neutrons. This is called a chain reaction. The reaction rate is controlled by control rods that absorb excess neutrons. The controllability of nuclear reactors depends on the fact that a smaller fraction of neutrons resulting from fission are delayed. The time delay between the fission and the release of neutrons slows down changes in reaction rates and gives time for moving the control rods to adjust the reaction rate. The fission nuclear power plant is generally composed of nuclear reactor in which the nuclear reactions generate heat take place. A cooling system which removes the heat from inside the reactor, a steam turbine which transforms the heat in mechanical energy, an electrical generator which transforms the mechanical energy into electrical energy, as opposed to light water reactors which use uranium-235. Fast breeder reactors use uranium-238 or thorium. The number of fuel cycles and breeder reactor combinations are considered to be sustainable and are renewable sources of energy. In 2006, it was estimated that with the seawater extraction, there was likely that some 5 billion years worth of uranium-238 for using breeder reactors. Breeder reactors are, however, being pursued as they have the potential to burn up all the actinides in the present inventory of nuclear waste, while also producing power and creating additional quantities of fuel for more reactors via the breeding process. Both China and India are building breeder reactors. The Indian 500 megawatt prototype fast breeder reactor is in the commissioning phase with the plans to build more. Another alternative to fast breeders are thermal breeder reactors that use uranium-233, bred from thorium as a fission fuel, the thorium fuel cycle. Thorium is about 3.5 times more common than uranium in the Earth's crust and has different geographic characteristics. This would extend the total practical fissionable resources base by 450%. India's three-stage nuclear power program features the use of a thorium fuel cycle in the third stage, as it has abundant thorium reserves but little uranium. The most important waste stream from nuclear power reactors is spent in nuclear fuel. From light water reactors, it is typically composed of 93% uranium, 4% fission products from the energy generating nuclear fission reactions, as well as about 1% transuranic actinides from unavoidable neutron capture events. The plutonium and other transuranics are responsible for the bulk of the long-term radioactivity, whereas the fission products are responsible for the bulk of the short-term radioactivity. The high-level radioactivity is the spent fuel that is generated from power production and requires treatment, management, and isolation from the environment. Technical issues in accomplishing this are considerable due to the extremely long periods, and particularly sublimation chrome, mildly radioactive waste remain potentially hazardous to living organisms, namely the long-lived fission products, technetium-99 and iodine-199, which dominate the waste stream in radioactivity after the more intensely radioactive short-lived fission products have decayed into stable elements, which takes approximately 300 years. To successfully isolate the LLFP waste from biosphere, either separation and transmutation or some form of variation of the syn-rock treatment and deep geological storage is commonly suggested. While in the US, spent fuel is presently in its entirety federally classified as a nuclear waste and is treated similarly in other countries, it is largely reprocessed to produce a partially recycled fuel known as mixed oxide fuel or MOX. For spent fuel that does not undergo reprocessing, the most concerning isotopes are the medium-lived transuranic elements, which are led by reactor-grade plutonium. The nuclear industry also produces a large volume of low-level radioactive waste in the form of contaminated items like clothing, hand tools, water purifier resins, and the materials of its reactor itself is built. Low-level waste can be stored on site until radiation levels are low enough to be disposed as ordinary waste, or it can be sent to a low-level waste disposal site. In countries with the nuclear power, radioactive waste accounts for less than 1% of the total industrial toxic waste, much of which remains hazardous for long periods. Overall, nuclear power produces far less waste material by volume than fossil fuel-based power plants. Coal burning plants are particularly noted for producing large amounts of toxic and mildly radioactive ash due to the concentrating naturally occurring metals and mildly radioactive materials in coal. The 2008 report from Oak Ridge National Laboratory concluded that coal power actually results in more radioactivity being released into the environment than nuclear power operation, and that the population effective dose equivalent or dose to the public from radiation from coal plants is 100 times as much as from the operation of nuclear power plants. Although coal ash is much less radioactive than spent nuclear fuel, on a weight per weight basis, coal ash is produced in much higher quantities per unit of energy generated, and this is directly released into the environment as fly ash, whereas nuclear plants use shielding to protect the environment from radioactive materials. For example, in dry cask storage vessels, disposal of nuclear waste is often considered the most politically divisive aspect of the life cycle of a nuclear power facility. Presently, waste is mainly stored at individual reactor sites, and there are about 430 locations around the world where radioactive material continues to accumulate. Some experts suggest that centralized underground repositories, which are well managed, guarded, and monitored, would be a vast improvement. There is an international consensus on the advisability of storing nuclear waste in deep geological repositories. With a lack of movement of nuclear waste in the 2 billion year old natural nuclear fission reactors in Oklahoma, given being cited as a source of essential information today. Most of thermal reactors run on a once through fuel cycle, mainly due to the low price of fresh uranium. So many reactors are also fueled with the recycled fissionable materials that remain in spent nuclear fuel. The most common fissionable material that is recycled is reactor-grade plutonium that is extracted from spent fuel. It is mixed with uranium oxide and fabricated into mixed oxide or MOX fuel. The first LWR design certified to operate on a full core of MOX fuel, the ABWR and the System 80 began to appear in the 1990s. The potential for recycling the spent fuel a second time is limited by undesirable neutron economy issues using second generation MOX fuel in thermal reactors. These issues do not affect fast reactors, which are therefore preferred in order to achieve the full energy potential of the original uranium. The only commercial demonstration of twice recycled high burn up fuel to date occurred in the Phoenix fast reactor, because thermal LWRs remain the most common reactor worldwide. The most typical form of commercial spent fuel recycling is to recycle the plutonium a single time as MOX fuel, as is done in France, where it is considered to increase the sustainability of the nuclear fuel cycle, reduce the attractiveness of spent fuel to theft, and lower the volume of high-level nuclear waste. Reprocessing of the civilian fuel from power reactors is also currently done in the UK, Russia, Japan, and India. The main constituent of spent fuel from the most common light water reactor is uranium, that is most slightly more enriched than the natural uranium, which can be recycled, though there is a lower incentive to do so. Most of these recovered uranium, or at times referred to as reprocessed uranium, remains in storage. It can, however, be used in a fast reactor, used directly as fuel in CANDU reactors, or re-enriched for another cycle through a LWR. The direct use of recovered uranium to fuel a CANDU reactor was first demonstrated at Pisan, China. The first re-enriched uranium reload to fuel a commercial LWR occurred in 1994 at the CROSS Unit 4, France. Re-enriching of reprocessed uranium is common in France and Russia. When reprocessed uranium, namely uranium-236, is part of the fuel of LWRs, it generates a spent fuel and plutonium isotope stream with a greater inherent self-protection than the ones through the fuel cycle. While reprocessing efforts, the potential recovery of up to 95% of the remaining uranium and plutonium fuel in spent nuclear fuel and the reduction in long-term radioactivity within the remaining waste. Reprocessing has been politically controversial because of the potential to contribute to nuclear proliferation and varied perceptions of increasing the vulnerability of nuclear terrorism, and because of its higher fuel cost compared to the once low fuel cycle. Similarly, while reprocessing reduces the volume of high fuel waste, it does not reduce the fission products that are the primary residual heat generating and radioactive substances for the first few centuries outside the reactor, thus still requiring an almost identical container spacing for the initial first few hundred years within proposed geological waste isolation facilities. However, much of the portion of the Yucca Mountain project and those similar to it primarily centered not around fission products, but the plutonium mine. Answer. That placed in the underground of unprocessed and reprocessed spent fuel will eventually become the financial cost of every nuclear power plant continues for some time after the facility has finished generating the last useful electricity. Once no longer commercially viable, nuclear reactors and uranium enrichment facilities are generally decommissioned, returning the facility and its parts to a safe enough level to be entrusted for other uses such as greenfield status. After a cooling off period, last decades, reactor core materials are dismantled and cut into small pieces to be packed in containers for interim storage or transmutation experiments. Nuclear reactors have three unique characteristics that affect the safety as compared to other power plants. Firstly, intense radioactive materials are present in a nuclear reactor. The release to the environment can be hazardous. Secondly, the fission products make up most of the intensely radioactive substances in the reactor continue to generate a significant amount of decay heat, even after the fission chain reaction has stopped. If the heat cannot be removed from the reactor, the fuel rods may overheat and release radioactive materials. Thirdly, a criticality accident, the rapid increase of reactor power is possible in certain reactor designs, and the chain reaction cannot be controlled. These three characteristics have to be taken into account when designing nuclear reactors. Many technologies and materials associated with the creation of nuclear power program have a dual use capability in that they can be used to make nuclear weapons if a country chooses to do so. When this happens, a nuclear power program can become a route, leading to a nuclear weapon or public annexed to a secret weapons program. The concern over Iran's nuclear activities is a case in point. A fundamental goal for global security is to minimize the nuclear proliferation risks associated with the expansion of nuclear power. The Global Energy Partnership was an international effort to create a distribution network in which developing countries in need of energy would receive nuclear fuel at a discounted rate in exchange for that nation agreeing to forego their own indigenous development of a uranium enrichment program. Nuclear power is is one of the leading low carbon power generation methods of producing electricity, and in terms of total life cycle greenhouse gas emissions per unit of energy generated, have emission values comparable to lower than renewable energy. The variation in percent absorbed natural background radiation averages 2.4 millisieverts globally, but frequently varies between 1 millisievert and 13 millisievert, depending in most part on the geology of a person resides upon. According to the United Nations, UNSCEAR, regular nuclear power plant operations, including the nuclear fuel cycle, increases the amount to 0.0002 millisieverts per year of public exposure as a global average. The average dose from operating on nuclear power plants to the local populations around them is less than 0.0001 millisieverts. The average dose to those living within 50 miles of a coal power plant, thermal power plant, why they call it as coal power plant, it's thermal power plant, is over three times this dose, 0.0003 millisieverts on the average. As of 2008 report, Chernobyl resulted the most affected surrounding populations and made recovery personnel receiving an average initial 50 to 100 millisieverts over a few hours to weeks, while the remaining global legacy of the worst nuclear power plant accident in average exposure is 0.002 millisieverts on the average, and is continually dropping at the decaying rate. From the initial high of 0.04 millisieverts per person average over the entire populace of the Northern Hemisphere in the year of the accident in 1986, slowing global warming requires a transition to a low carbon economy, mainly by burning far less fuel, fossil fuel. Limiting global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius is technically possible if no fossil fuel power plants, no new fossil fuel power plants are built from the year 2019. They're not doing that. Developed nations, the economically feasible geography for new hydropower is lacking. Every geographically suitable area largely already exploited. Proponents of wind and solar energy claim these resources alone could eliminate the need for nuclear power. Nuclear power stations require approximately 1 square kilometer of land per typical reactor. Proponents of nuclear energy regard it as a sustainable energy source that reduces carbon emissions and increases energy security by decreasing dependence on imported energy sources. Opponents believe that nuclear power poses many threats to people and the environment, such as the risk of nuclear weapons proliferation and terrorism. They also contend that reactors are complex machines where many things can and have gone wrong. In years past, they have argued that when all the energy intensive stages of the nuclear fuel chain are considered, from uranium mining to nuclear decommissioning, nuclear power is neither a low carbon nor an economical feasible electricity source. Hybrid nuclear power is a proposed means of generating power by use of a combination of nuclear fission and fusion process. Nuclear fusion reactions have the potential to be safer and generate less radioactive waste than fission. These reactions appear potentially viable, though technically quite difficult, and have to yet to be created on a scale that could be used in a functional power plant. Fusion power has been under a theoretical and experimental investigation since the 1950s. There are quite a few nuclear power plants in India with an aggregate power generation capacity of 9,600 megawatt hour, biggest being at Koorangala, Tirunelveli district, with an installed capacity of 6,000 megawatt hour. Besides, 40,820 megawatt hour is proposed to be generated through additional nuclear power plants proposed. Majority of electrical power, about 71%, is generated through thermal power plants in India, the rest through hydel, wind, solar, and nuclear. Nuclear power is the largest source of electricity in India after thermal, hydroelectric, and renewable sources of electricity. As of 2016, India has 22 nuclear reactors in operation. At 7 sites, having an installed capacity of 6,780 megawatts and producing a total of 30,292.91 gigawatt hour of electricity. 11 more reactors are under construction to generate additional 8,100 megawatt. Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited, NPCIL, is a government-owned corporation of India based in Mumbai, which is responsible for the generation of nuclear power for electricity. NPCIL is administrated by the Department of Atomic Energy, Government of India. Tarapur is the world's largest nuclear power station in India. The Union Government on May 18, 2017 has cleared a proposal of building 10 nuclear power plants to add 7,000 megawatt to India's nuclear power generation capacity. This will be the indigenous 700 megawatt pressurized heavy water reactors. India and Russia signed deal for two nuclear reactors. India and Russia signed a pact for setting up the last units of the Kudankulam nuclear power plant with Moscow's help in Tamil Nadu. As discussed, the cost of power generation using nuclear energy will be economical in the long run, and pollution is also limited compared to thermal power plants. On the contrary, consequences of an accident at a thermal nuclear power plant is much more disastrous compared to other power generation plants. Radiation is a major hazard of nuclear power plants. Remember the long-term effects of accidents at nuclear power plants, especially TMI, US, Chernobyl, USSR, presently Ukraine, Daiichi, Japan. So experts and scientists besides administrators need to devise ways and regulations using appropriate technology to mitigate the effect of accidents at nuclear power plants, safe disposal of spent fuel rods, nuclear terrorism, etc. Nuclear fission is a fusion is a better option than nuclear fission. So speed of work on nuclear fusion reactors and success is not an impossibility. Debates, discussion, and open ended topics like this can go on forever. You know, let me pull the plug here. We'll meet again real soon with another interesting topic. Some of the statements, views expressed are solely mine based on limited knowledge gained over 6 decades of first-hand experience. Always watch these videos with the closed caption for absolute 100% comprehension as per my sincere recommendation, zillion times so far. I know I rushed through to complete the presentation within 20 minutes max. This is the time limit I had set myself as a norm to retain the viewers' attention. But of course, nowadays I exceed this time limit. Today, I think I have taken maybe thrice the time, 1 hour. That's because I make honest attempts to cover the selected topic more elaborately, including so many intricate fine details, referring a wide variety of sources, in particular Wikipedia, quite extensively, besides articles and books published recently. Besides, of course, I sprinkle my own salt and pepper and season it with my personal experiences so far in my life and also inclusion. Stay at home as much as possible to maintain social distancing attributed to pandemic novel COVID-19. And prolong your lifespan, lead a healthy life. God alone can put a stop to natural or unnatural events, maybe bio war and cyber war events like pandemics, human heat apocalypse, and extinction of all sentient species on earth for no fault of others. Rest in peace and harmony.